Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ikeda.
Hello friends, we have discussed about the circular linked list. Also, we have defined with the two functions. First function was insert at the start. Okay, and also we have done with the insert at the end. So the element was insert at the start of the linked list or end of the linked list. Now what if I want to insert the element in some random position given at the linked list? So to do this, I would need to take the value and position from the user. Okay, so two things I need from the user. That is, first one is your value, that is the data of the node, and also the position where we want that particular node to be inserted into the given linked list. Okay, now we have defined a function called as insert at position. There we have two parameters, val and position. Okay, val will define what? Data of node, and position variable will be defined as the position of node. Okay, once we get this val and position, then we need to start with the execution of insert at position. First, I will define a variable object called as NPTR. Okay, this object is of which class? Node class. It will be having value and null. So NPTR will be having which parts? Val, which I'm going to take from the user, and null. Okay, so this object has, then I've created another reference variable PTR. Okay, so PTR is going to have what? Start. Okay, so start will point to which now? PTR. Clear? Now, as you may be aware, I need to take the position from the user. So my position will be what? It will be -1, whichever the user gives. Okay, because I want to insert my node into that position. Okay, so I will be taking the position before that one. That is, my position will be defined by the user and I will be taking it back 1. So I need to write down POS, that is the position of the node, equal to POS minus 1. Okay, so POS minus 1. Let's take example, position of which the user wants to put up is 5. Okay, so 5 minus 1. So my position becomes now 4. So I need to insert the between 4 and 5. Okay, so my node will be inserted at 5 position. That's why I need to write down POS equal to position minus 1. Clear? Now, after this, I need to go through the entire linked list to find out the particular value. Okay, to find out the position where I can insert the value. So first I need to have the size. Okay, so size is going to give me the size of linked list. Okay, the size is going to give me the size of linked list. I start with 1 and I will be going till n minus 1, that is size minus 1. Okay, so I start with 1 and I go size minus 1, because size is going to increment as the elements are added. So I need to insert that a particular node in between that given node. Okay, so I write down I equal to 1, I less than equal to what? We can say I less than equal to size minus 1. That is, I will be putting up the values. If I say size is 6, okay, so I will be going from 1 to 5. Clear? So I will be what? Less going till 4 only. Okay, so I equal to 1, I size minus 1. Okay, size is, let's say 6 minus 1, 5. So I will be going from 1 to 5. Clear? Now I need to make sure my I value is what I need to insert. Once I've taken the position from the user, okay, I need to go one step back. That is, I need to subtract one value. That will become my position. Okay, and I'm going to make sure that my I variable is going to point to that position where user wants to enter. Okay, so I write if I equal to position. So once I get this value, that is the position where user wants to insert the value. Okay, so I write down if I equal to position. I get the value, then I come to the another parts. Okay. Again, I have defined a new variable called as TMP. Okay, that is going to call the function called as getLink. Okay, so PTR which I have created. Okay, this is the value having the start. Okay, so I'm writing node tmp equal to ptr.getLink. So ptr.getLink will give the value and put up into tmp. So tmp is going to have which value? GetLink value. Okay, ptr.getLink will give me tmp. Now ptr is going to set the link. Now which link I am going to put up on a value where my mptr is going to point. Okay, so I'm writing ptr dot set link is nptr. Okay, so ptr dot set link as nptr. Clear? Now next will be what I need to make sure that this value is put up. So I'm writing nptr dot set link equal to tmp, which is what I got the values. Okay, so nptr dot set link tmp, that is my temporary variable. Okay, so nptr dot set link would set the value in particular position. Once I've done with this one, that is I've inserted the node at position, I need to break it up. So to break out of the loop, I'm writing the statement called as break. Okay, I've set the values, I've set the link as tmp where I want to insert the values. So nptr dot set link has set the values. Okay, once I've done with this one, that means I've inserted the node into the position where user wanted. So I need to come out of that particular loop. To do this, I'm going to use the statement called as break. Okay, so break would come out of this loop. Once I'm out of this loop, I need to once again write down the position of the ptr, which is the reference variable I've started with. Okay, so I'm writing ptr equal to ptr dot get link. Now this will give me the link, that is the value it needs to point it up. So ptr will be ptr dot get link. So this value will be transferred to which variable now? Ptr variable. Okay, once I've done with this one, one node is added into the link list, so my size is going to increase now. That's why I'm writing size plus plus. Okay, so once one node is inserted at the position, my size is going to increase. That's why I'm going to write size equal to size plus one, in which a form I can write it down, size plus plus. Like this, I can insert the elements at the given position. So the elements can be inserted at the start of the linked list, it can be inserted at the end of the linked list, and also it can be inserted at the position of the given choice by the user in the given linked list. So important point is to remember here is that we need to find out the position. So to get that, I'm going to use variables. Which one? Size. Thank you for watching this video. Please subscribe to eKreator channel.